Allah will continue our thoughts about al-Iman. One of the definitions that we didn't mention last time, that when you study any Islamic studies, especially in Aqidah, they will tell you that Iman is, the definition of Iman is the belief in the heart, a statement you say with your tongue, and action you do with your body. And it will increase with obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and will decrease with sinning or disobedience. And we have some different opinions, and this is important for us to reflect on. Remember the model that we said that Islam is like three stories building, floor one, two, three. First floor is Islam, second floor is Iman, third floor is Ihsan. So if someone describing only the second floor, if he asked about Iman and he described only the second floor, this is really the Iman, because this is A'mal al-Batin or A'mal al-Qulub, the action of the heart. But the heart is not doing any physical action, it is internal belief, and this is what we call by the actions of the heart. So if he described only the Iman, the internal act, the second floor only. But someone, which is the definition I mentioned, when he described the whole thing, because there is no way you have second floor without having the first floor. You cannot have Iman without Islam. You cannot have Iman without praying and fasting and so on. Both of them are seeing the Iman from different angle, from different view. And this is why the definitions are complementing, not contradicting, okay? The second thing that we want to mention, inshallah, and continue, is the nida that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu, O who believe. And we have this calling from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers more than 80 times in the Quran. And after each calling from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have an order from Allah. We have an action to do. So the theory is every action will help you to come close to Iman. It will help you to get to the second level, and it will increase your Iman. So inshallah, we will not cover all of them because we don't have time in Ramadan, but we will take some random orders from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, random calling from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and see how we can implement them, how we can practice them in our life. The first nida that we have, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kulu min tayyibati ma razaqnakum. O who believe, eat from the good things which we have provided for you. Washkuru lah, and be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the second one. So today we have two commands from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One is to eat from the good things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this beautiful hadith, this ayah, mentioned that there is a lot of provision that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving us. But we have to choose the tayyibat, we have to choose the good things. And the second thing, that the good, when we make money, when we gain anything, we have to gain it from halal. We have to take it from halal way. And actually what the ulama said, that the al-aklu min al-halal, to eat from halal, from allowed source, will make your dua acceptable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if someone eat from haram, it will be a reason that the halal, the dua will not be accepted, and even the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not be accepted. So you know, I have many people, artists and belly dancers, they make a lot of money, and then in Ramadan they spend too much money and they make iftar for everyone, and they go for umrah. No, you don't have to do this. Make money from halal and don't inna Allah tayyib la yaqbal illa tayyib. Allah is good and will not accept anything except from good source. The second thing, that this order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not only for the believer, it's actually also for the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have many examples that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to Rasulullah in the beginning of Surah Al-Ahzab, Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu taqillah, O prophet of Allah, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then in another ayat for us, for the believer, Ya ladina amanu taqullah, O who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have taqwa. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this and this is what Rasulullah said in the hadith, O people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tayyib, Allah is good, will not accept anything but good from good source. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the believers the same he ordered the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, O messengers, Ya ayyuha rusul, kulu min at-tayyibat, O messengers, eat from good source. okay, or the good things. And then he told the believers, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, which is ayah we have, كُلُّ مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ, eat from a good source. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you have to imagine, this is very important, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanding Rasulullah sallam and all the messengers, the best of the best, and in the same time ordering us, it will show how important this command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another ayah reflecting on the same, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيُحِلُّ لَهُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَيُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهُمُ الْخَبَائِثِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes lawful for them the good things and prohibits the evil things and so on. And also this, subhanAllah, I'm not saying the ayah talking about this, but we can reflect on it, that you know what we know, that what we know about organic food, to eat good, you know, all this GMO and all this engineered modified food and all these problems that we are facing in our modern time, because you know we are not trying to eat the good things. You know, now they have organic milk, they have organic meat, they have, as if, and we don't have this 20 years ago, 30 years ago, we don't have this term. When you say organic, meaning the non-organic has a problem. It's fishy. It's something, you know, it's not good. So, and again, this ayah also, I'm not saying it's directly commanding us to do, but we can reflect, we can understand from it this meaning. The other command, and again, we go quickly on them. Everyone will work by himself on this command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second thing is washkuru lillah, and be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you really worship Him. We have in Islam, we have to, and also in Arabic language, we have to differentiate between alhamd wa shukr. Alhamd is greater than shukr. We say shukr in Urdu, right? We say alhamd in Urdu, correct? So alhamd is greater than shukr. Alhamd for the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But ash-shukr only for the bounties from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even we use it, of course, with the difference in human level. We can say ahmadu fi'alak. I praise your actions because the good character you have, even if you don't do good thing to me. And I say thank you, ashkuruk, because you did something good to me. So this is the difference between alhamd wa shukr. So in this ayah, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the good things that He provided us. Okay? And we have many ahadith that Rasulullah used to pray all night until his feet will be swollen, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Aisha radiallahu anha said to your Rasulullah, why you are doing this? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all your sins, the past one and the future one. And he said, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Shall I not be a grateful slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So, a shukr not only by tongue, not say just thank you, oh Allah. No, you have to thank Allah by tongue and have the appreciation in your heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your actions of ibadah, your sadaqah, your giving, and all this action is part of the action, the shukr. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Dawood, اعملوا آل داود شكرا. يعني practice or act the family of Dawood عليه الصلاة والسلام in a thankful way. Because the action is a way of thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another hadith of Sallam talking about, wondering about the matter of the believer. Everything happened to him is good. If something good happened to him, he will be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If something difficult and hard, he will be patient. So, and this is why Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah said that Islam, and this is another view to Islam, he said the whole deen is two parts, as-sabr wa shukr, patience and thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because everything happened in our life, either in our eyes, not for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is always good. And with this, what, how we believe. But in my eyes, sometimes I see something good, and in my eyes, something I see something bad. Okay? But in both cases, I will deal with sabr or I deal with shukr. And then we have the last one, the last hadith, which is adhkar, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the morning, when you say, Allahumma ma asbaha bi min ni'matin aw bi ahadin min khalqika, fa minka wahdaka la sharika lak, fa laka alhamdu wa laka ash-shukr, faqad adda shukra yawmi. Whoever say this every day in the morning or at night, faqad adda shukra laylati. So whatever, when you say this dua in the morning, before sunrise, and at night before sunset, and you say, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever bounties, whatever giving or gifts you giving to me or to any one of your creations, it is from you, ya Allah, no partner with you. I praise you, hamd, and I thank you, shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, so this is the two actions that we need to reflect and practice as much as we can during the month of Ramadan, to eat from the good things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided us and to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه الغفور الرحيم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Thank you.